Almighty God, grant us a quiet night and peace at the last.
Amen.
By day, O God,
you grant your steadfast love,
and at night your song is with me.
A prayer to the God of my life.
All praise to thee, my God, this night, for all the blessings of the light. Keep me, oh, keep me, King of kings.
Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. I confess to God Almighty, before the whole company of heaven, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned by my own fault, in thought, word, and deed. I pray God Almighty to have mercy on me. Forgive me all my sins, and bring me to everlasting life.
Almighty and merciful God, grant you healing, pardon, and forgiveness of all your sins. Amen. I confess to God Almighty, before the whole company of heaven, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned by my own fault in thought, word, and deed. I pray God Almighty to have mercy on me, forgive me all my sins, and bring me to everlasting life.
Almighty and merciful God, grant you healing, pardon, and forgiveness of all your sins. Amen.
I will bless the Lord at all times. The praise of God shall ever be in my mouth.
I will glory in the Lord. Let the lowly hear and rejoice.
Proclaim with me the greatness of the Lord. Let us exalt God's name together.
The Lord who answered me
your faces be ashamed.
I called in my affliction, and the Lord heard me and saved me from all my troubles.
The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear the Lord and delivers them.
Taste and see that the Lord is good. Happy are they who take refuge in God.
Good evening. I'd like to share with you today the psalm that was read last Sunday. It's Psalm 8. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You whose glory is chanted above the heavens, out of the mouths of infants and children, you have set up a fortress against your enemies to silence the foe and avenger. When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars you have set in their courses. What are mere mortals that you should be mindful of them? Human beings that you should care for them? Yet you have made them little less than divine. With glory and honor you crown them. You have made them rule over the works of your hands. You have put all things under their feet. All flocks and cattle, even the wild beasts of the field, the birds of the air, the fish of the sea, and whatever passes along the paths of the sea. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. This particular psalm, Psalm 8, is one of the few psalms that is a direct praise of God. It doesn't call upon the congregation to praise God. It's the psalmist expressing his awe and wonder at God's creation. I can picture the psalmist on a night, pitch dark outside, no lights in houses or on the street corners, and he gazes up into the heavens. And he marvels at all of the stars, the moon, everything so bright and clear up in the heavens. And when he pictures that, he imagines God standing outside of all of creation, encompassing the vastness of the universe. And he wonders in his mind, if God is out and beyond all of that, how is it that God pays attention to me, a human being, a mortal, so insignificant in the vast scheme of things? It's amazing that God cares for me. You know, we've seen pictures from the Hubble telescope. We've seen evidence that the universe is incredibly vast, beyond our imaginations even. And so when we consider that, when we think about God who is outside of that creation, being concerned about us as individuals, it should put us in awe, standing amazed that this God would care for each one of us. I know that during this time of the year, that many of us have the opportunity to go out and enjoy God's creation. Maybe it's just a walk around the neighborhood or out to a lake place. But as we do that, we too can appreciate the gift of God's creation and know that this God cares for us. This God cares for us whether we're rejoicing or in grief. This God cares for us, whether it's in the midst of relaxing or recognizing the reality of riots. This God cares for us, wants to protect us, and walks along with us. That's what Jesus came to tell us again and again. This Jesus, who was proclaimed Emmanuel, God with us, reminds us as he leaves his disciples, remember, I'm with you always to the end of the age. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. We rejoice in that. Amen.
Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
Into your hands I commend my spirit.
You have Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Into your hands I commend my spirit.
Hear my prayer, O Lord.
Listen to my cry.
Keep me as the apple of your eye.
Hide me in the shadow of your wings.
In righteousness I shall see you.
When I awake, your presence will give me joy.
Gracious God, we give you thanks for the day, especially for the good we were permitted to give and to receive. The day is now past, and we commit it to you. We entrust to you the night. We rest securely, for you are our help, and you neither slumber nor sleep. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, amen.
gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Now in peace I will lie down and sleep.
You alone, O God, make me secure.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.